Students, in today's session I'm going to discuss about methods of preparation and properties of potassium dichromate in an easy way. Potassium dichromate formula is K2Cr2O7. It is an ionic compound and which is in orange red color, which dissociates into K plus ions and Cr2O7 2 minus ion. The Cr2O7 2 minus ion is dichromate ion. This is the structure of dichromate ion. See here, Cr double bond O, O minus, and CrO, Cr double bond O, O minus. Here, these electrons involves in delocalization. Because of this resonance, all the CrO bond lengths are same in dichromate ion. One of the previous year question is, how many CrO bond lengths are same in Cr2O7 2 minus? What is your answer? Due to resonance, due to resonance 6 CrO bond lengths are same. This bond length, this one, and CrO, 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 all are same in Cr2O7 2 minus. This is one of the JE question. Let us see the methods of preparation. Potassium dichromate is prepared from chromite ore, which is very very important method. The formula of chromite ore is FeOCr2O7. FeOCr2O3. This chromite ore is made to react with sodium carbonate. Actually, if you do the roasting means heating the ore with sodium carbonate in the presence of oxygen. Whenever we do roasting, this chromite ore converts into sodium chromate, Na2CrO4. This is an yellow colored compound. What is this, students? This is sodium chromate. This sodium chromate, in the presence of acidic medium like H2SO4, it converts into sodium dichromate, Na2Cr2O7. What is this? This is sodium dichromate. This sodium dichromate is made to react with KCl. Potassium is more reactive than the sodium, and this potassium replaces the sodium from the sodium dichromate, and we get K2Cr2O7. Chromite ore is made to react with Na2CO3. In the presence of air, we get yellow colored compound, that is sodium chromate. Sodium chromate, in the presence of acidic media, we get sodium dichromate. Sodium dichromate is made to react with more reactive metal, halide, that is KCl, and finally we get potassium dichromate. Let us see the second method, one more method for the preparation of see here, Na2CrO4, which on dissociation it gives actually CrO4 2 minus, right? This is what chromate ion. This chromate ion, in the presence of acidic media like H plus ion, it converts into Cr2O7 2 minus, right? It dissociates and we get 2Na plus plus Cr2O7 2 minus. And what I want to say is, chromate ion in acidic media, it converts into dichromate ion. So, chromate ion is converting into dichromate ion in acidic medium. Cr2O7 2 minus in basic medium, it converts into CrO4 2 minus and H plus ions. Means this is dichromate, ion, and this is chromate ion. What I want to make clear is, in the presence of acidic medium, chromate ion converts into dichromate ion. In the presence of basic medium, dichromate ion converts into chromate ion. Is it clear, students? So the thing is, in acidic medium, which ion is more stable in nature? Which is more stable in acidic medium? See, in acidic medium, chromate is converting into dichromate. Means dichromate is more stable in acidic medium. Dichromate ion is more stable. In basic medium, dichromate ion is converted into chromate ion. Means in basic medium, chromate ion is more stable. That's why dichromate ion is converting into chromate ion. That's the reason in basic medium, which is more stable? Chromate ion is more stable. This is Cr2O7 2-, which is orange red color, and Cr4O4 2- is chromate ion. This is yellow color, right? And equilibrium establishes between these two, and K2Cr2O7, it reacts with H2SO4. With cold H2SO4, what are the products? With the hot H2SO4, what are the products? These are the important reactions. See here. K2Cr2O7 reacts with a cold H2SO4. The product formed here is chromic anhydride. Very, very important. What is the product, students? Chromic anhydride. Potassium dichromate reacts with hot sulfuric acid. It forms Cr2SO4 thrice and it releases oxygen gas. With hot concentrated H2SO4, what are the products? Cr2SO4 thrice and it releases oxygen gas. If you see here, in K2Cr2O7, oxidation state of chromium is +6. In this Cr2SO4 thrice, it dissociates and we get 2Cr3+ ion, right? Cr3+, what is the oxidation state? +3. Means one chromium is changing from +6 to +3. The difference is 3, right? And for two chromiums, the difference is reduction is how much? 6 by 6 units. Means equivalent weight of potassium dichromate is actually molecular weight by valency factor, right? Here, what is the valency factor? 6. Number of electron change is 6. Molecular weight by 6 is the equivalent weight of potassium dichromate. And potassium dichromate, it is undergoing reduction. Itself, it undergoes a reduction and it makes the other element to undergo oxidation. That is the reason potassium dichromate acts as a good oxidizing agent. Let us see the most important reactions of potassium dichromate. Potassium dichromate K2Cr2O7, just now we discussed, it converts into Cr3+, means it is undergoing reduction, decrease in oxidation number, reduction, and it oxidizes the other elements, like it oxidizes I- into I2, and potassium dichromate oxidizes Cl- into Cl2, it oxidizes Fe2+ into Fe3+, it oxidizes H2S into sulfur, it oxidizes SO2 into SO4 2-, it oxidizes S2O3 2- into SO4 2-, it oxidizes NO2- into NO3-, it oxidizes SN2+ into SN4+. These all are very, very important reactions. If you observe here, in these reactions, the elements are changing from their lower oxidation states to higher oxidation states. Here arsenic is in +3 and here arsenic is in +5 state. Tin is in +2, here +4. It is in +3, it is in +5. Means it is in +4, +2, it is in +6. It is in +4, it is in +6, -2, 0, +2, +3. Means every element is undergoing oxidation. And here K2Cr2O7 is acting as an oxidizing agent. These reactions are very, very important. And K2CR2O7 oxidizes alcohols into aldehydes and aldehydes further into acids. We get acid. Let us see the reaction with H2O2. Potassium dichromate reacts with hydrogen peroxide in the presence of sulfuric acid, means in the presence of acidic medium. The product is, this is very, very important students, the product is CrO5. This is the product. This is chromic peroxide. What is this? Chromic peroxide or chromium diperoxide also we can say, and it is having butterfly structure. This is the structure of CrO5. It is having two peroxide bonds. This is one peroxide bond and this is one more peroxide bond. The oxidation state of oxygen in peroxide is -1. So Cr plus this oxygen, oxidation state is -2, and plus how many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 oxygens are there in peroxide bonds, with peroxide bonds. Total sum is equal to 0. Cr plus each, this oxygen is -2 oxidation state, plus 4 into the oxygen which is present in peroxide linkage is -1, which is equal to 0. Then Cr is 2 minus 4. Then Cr is equal to plus 6. Oxidation state of chromium in CrO5 is, oxidation state of Cr is plus 6, not plus 10. What is the oxidation state? Plus 6 is the oxidation state. And this K2Cr2O7 is useful in qualitative analysis to test the chloride ion. Potassium dichromate in acidic medium reacts with this chloride ions and they release reddish brown colored vapors, means this red colored vapors because of the formation of CrO2Cl2. This is called chromyl chloride. What is this? Chromyl chloride. Chromyl chloride. This formation of reddish brown vapors confirms that that particular salt is having reddish brown vapors are liberated in the test tube. What is this? Take the your salt. If it is having chloride ion, when we are adding, whenever we add K2CR2O7 with H2SO4, we get reddish brown color fumes, which confirms that it is having the chloride ion. This is called as chromyl chloride test. Chromyl chloride test. This test is used for what? Detection of chloride ion. I hope you like this video. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, give thumbs up and try to share with your friends.